Greetings, Eric Becker from New Zealand, a naturopath from way down under in New Zealand. Thanks for coming back and checking out my video. I'm the author of a book called Candida Crusher and also the formulator of a range of products called Canzida. That's with an X in the middle. Thanks for checking out my videos. I do appreciate all the support I'm getting, and I've got so much stuff thrown at me from subscribers, just different questions all the time. I can't obviously answer every single question I get, but I've got a few pages of questions today we're going to go through. So these are going to be individualized videos, and I hope you people out there get some useful information from some of the content of these videos. So never be afraid to ask questions. Okay, let's start off with a question from Timothy O'Hara. So Timothy is writing here, "I hold this gentleman to such high regard, and I even use his supplements, for they are the best. But this is one major thing I disagree with him on completely. This heavy denial of die-off makes no sense to me. Maybe my overgrowth is just that bad, I don't know, but I'm either feeding the candida or I'm not. And when I'm not, the symptoms are extreme. Some days I feel like I'm going to die, in fact. I wish he could make a video on how to combat the die-off, rather than simply saying, oh, avoid die-off by taking it easy." Okay, Tim, good question, good question. Well, let's get one thing straight. I don't deny die-off whatsoever. Absolutely not. I'm not denying die-off. I do agree it exists. I've experienced it myself really bad. I've had many, many patients who've experienced die-off. So let's get that straight right from the beginning. I'm not denying die-off. What I am denying is the fact that most people don't think they can avoid die-off. Okay, it can be avoided. In 99% of cases, it can be avoided. That's what I'm saying. But you can obviously easily get die-off. So the best advice I can give you, Tim, if you want to avoid any kind of like extreme reactions with any kind of gut presentation, so we're talking SIBO, candida, parasites, you know, whatever you've got happening in your gut and you want to correct it, if you want to avoid an aggravation, the first thing you do is you test your gut to see what the hell's going on in there, okay? You don't just make wild assumptions or go to doctors who say, just try this or just try that, you know, this is going to work. Whenever someone uses the word try, T-R-Y, okay, it means they're basically having what we call in Australia a stab in the dark. They haven't got a clue what they're stabbing at. They're just basically firing off randomly into space hoping they're going to shoot a bird, you know. So unless you really understand what you're dealing with, it's pretty darn difficult to target, you know, what you want to clean up in the gut. I'm not advocating everyone to do stool testing. I've done incredible amount of stool testing in the last 10 years, comprehensive stool analysis. I cannot tell you guys how many people out there have been so incredibly annoyed and disappointed that they never had the test done previously by their doctor or by somebody else, that they wasted 5 or 10 years of their life not knowing what was going on internally until they checked it out. Now, a random stool test by the doctor is going to be pretty darn useless because it's not comprehensive. So we don't even know if we're dealing with Candida, Tim, unless we've got solid evidence that we can see that a live yeast culture comes from your digestive system. You may have a bacterial overgrowth. You may have a lack of beneficial bacteria. You may make assumptions thinking that you've got die-off from killing Candida, when in fact you may not have killed anything at all. So unless you really truly understand the facts, okay, to me it's like anything in life, you need to have evidence, right? If you get pulled over by a police officer and the policeman says, excuse me sir, have you been drinking tonight, and you absolutely know you haven't been drinking, you'll quite willingly give a breath sample because you know you're going to be in the clear. But that police officer doesn't know. He or she needs to know, has this guy been drinking? So they say, could you please blow in this, sir? Now that's going to either hang you or not hang you. Now the stool test to me is like the breathalyzer test, okay? It's either going to confirm or deny the presence of something. Providing you work with a good lab, it's going to give you great information, and then you can really, really intelligently work out what's the best approach for me from this day forward. Do I need to build up my gut? Do I need to kill bad bacteria? Do I need to eradicate candida? Have I got a parasite? You know, what the heck's going on? Because I'm not feeling good. That's the intelligent approach, right? It's going to cost you maybe $300 or $400 for a stool test. You've got great information. If the test is performed properly, You've got the right kind of information to act on and to work, you know, forward. So what the hell does this relate to die-off? Well, by having the right kind of information before you start treatment, you can avoid 99.5% of aggravations in your gut. And if you do get them, you can very easily stop them from ramping up to becoming very bad die-off reactions. So die-off reactions occur from overstepping the mark, from killing too much too soon. If you start very slowly and very cautiously, even with a very heavy load of candida, you can manage the reactions you get much more effectively than if you don't know what the hell you're dealing with. So Tim, my question to you is, have you done a stool test? If you have done a stool test, send me the inform me through the YouTube channel and send me your PDF, and I'll be happy to interpret that online for you for no charge at all. I'm quite happy to do that for subscribers. So if you haven't done a stool test, I would urge you to do one to know what the heck is going on internally. So that's my take on it. I'm not denying that die-off, you know, exists. Doesn't exist. It does exist, but it can be avoided and seriously managed through the correct kind of protocol. That's the point I'm trying to make here in this video, okay? So it's not a heavy denial. Now, you're also saying here, some days I feel like I'm going to die. In fact, I wish you could make a video on how to combat the die-off rather than simply say, oh, avoid die-off by taking it easy. How to combat die-off is by stopping all treatment immediately and taking it very easy, okay? By stopping all kinds of treatment you're doing, any kind of supplement you're taking, basically your body should within 3 to 5 days slowly start to come back to a normal state, right? It can take a week, but it will. And then when the dust is settled, do a test, all right? Maybe wait 2 weeks if you're taking probiotics, but then do a test. And then let's see what is left after the dust is settled, so we can determine what is the correct approach to go forward. So, long video, but I hope it gave you some information, Tim. Don't be afraid to ask a question back. Cheers. Thanks for the question.